Bam, Mr. Tarot. In this video, we are going to look at two examples of using Cramer's rule to allow us to solve systems of equations in a different manner. We're going to do first a 2x2 matrix and then a 3x3 matrix. The Cramer's rule is really going to be a much more efficient way of solving that larger 3x3 matrix system of equations compared to using the Gaussian elimination method. And of course, we do know now with technology that all of these ways of solving these problems by hand are a lot quicker than just typing them into a calculator and getting an answer. But then again, what's the calculator really doing? We don't really understand the process that's being used to solve that work. And maybe someday you'll be programming a computer or calculator to help somebody else. So at any rate, Cramer's rule. Let C be the coefficient matrix of the system of equations. So we have AX plus BY equals M, and FX plus GY is equal to N. So the matrix C, the coefficient matrix, is going to be you identifying, well, we have the variables of X and Y in here, and all the other variables, A, B, F, G, M, N, these are all going to be constants in the problem. And the matrix A, B, F, G is going to be your coefficients matrix. What comes in front of the X's and what comes in front of the Y's, or whatever variables that you have in your problem. The solution to the systems of equation, or that system of equations, is going to be X is going to be equal to, now, this MN. These are the constants that the equations are set equal to. You can see that we've taken out the A and the F in the coefficient matrix and replaced them with the constants, the values, the numerical values that the equations are equal to. Notice the X and Y's again are on one side and just this constant value on the right. So if you want to solve for X, you take the coefficient matrix, you take out the coefficients of X, and you plug in those values of M and N in that first column. Keep the B and the G, keep the coefficients of Y in there, and find the determinant of that 2x2 matrix. Then divide it by the determinant of matrix C, just the matrix that we have the coefficients of X and Y in there. The formula, or my textbook, is using just the determinant of C in the denominator because we're going to have the same value in the denominator for both of those steps of solving for X and Y. So we're just saving some writing there. And then Y is going to be go back to that coefficient matrix, put the A and the F back in, put the coefficients of X back in, but this time take out the coefficients of Y and replace it with those constants of M and N again. And then once again, find the determinant of that 2x2 matrix and divide it by the determinant of C, the coefficient matrix of the system. Here's what it's going to look like in practice. We're going to solve X minus 2, Y equals 5, and 3X plus Y is equal to negative 4. So C is going to be, matrix C is going to be equal to 1, 3 in the first column, and negative 2, 1 in the second. And then the determinant of C is going to be equal to 1 times 1 minus negative 2 times 3. Almost running out of room there. So the determinant of C is going to be equal to 1 minus a negative 6, or 1 minus negative 6, just showing all the work. These negatives are going to cancel out, of course, and we get 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. Okay, now that's going to, that value of 7 is going to be in the denominator of both of my fractions as I go through the, continue the process to find X and Y. So let's pick a different color here. Let's see the X. X is going to be equal to, well, we have matrix C. We're going to take out the coefficients of X and plug in 5 and negative 4. So we have the determinant of 5 and negative 4, these constants off to the right. Negative 2, 1, keep that in there, over the determinant of C, which we already know is equal to 7. Okay, so we have 5 times 1 minus negative 2 times negative 4 over 7, and that comes out to be 5 minus, now negative 2 times negative 4 is positive 8, so 5 minus 8 over 7, or negative 3 sevenths. Now, let's take one more step and find out what y is equal to. So y is equal to, go back to this matrix C, your constant constant matrix, but now take out the coefficients of y and again plug in that 5 and negative 4. So we're going to go back to the first column being 1 and 3. The second column now is going to be the 5 and the negative 4. And again, it's going to be over 7, the determinant of C. So that's going to be equal to 1 times negative 4 minus 5 times 3 over 7. We get negative 4 minus 15. And our value of y is going to be negative 19 over 7. Now don't forget, when you have, we have x to the first, y to the first, we have a linear system here. So this is basically going to, when we solve x minus 2y equals 5 and 3x plus y equals negative 4, we're finding out what value of x and y will make both of those equations true. We're going to find out where those equations, these are equations of lines because they all have exponents of 1, where these lines intersect. And these two lines intersect at the point of negative 3 sevenths and negative 19 over sevenths. If you want to make sure that those answers are right, you have to plug that value of x and y into both the first equation and the second equation, because both of those equations are supposed to be at that same point. Doing Cramer's rule on 2x2 systems like this, where two equations and two unknowns, is really not that much quicker than doing either the substitution or the linear combination method. What really its benefit, however, is you can see both of our answers are fractional values, yet we did not really have to deal with any fractions through the process of solving this equation. So in that respect, it can be easier. I just did this very, very quickly in my head. It took me longer to write it than actually do it. And yet we had those fractional values. If I did substitution or linear combination method, those would have had to been dealt with a little bit more carefully through the process of solving the question. Otherwise, if you have whole number answers, probably would be quicker to do substitution or the linear combination method of solving those 2x2 systems. However, when you have three equations and three unknowns, then this process is a big time saver. You're going to see a lot of writing in the next example, but again, I'm showing all the steps because I'm trying to teach you how to do it. Once you get the knack down, you can probably do a lot of this multiplication and arithmetic in your head, and it'll go even faster. So let's see what that second example is going to look like when we have three equations and three unknowns. Okay, last example. We're going to solve 2x plus y minus 2z is equal to negative 1, 4x minus 2y minus z equals 5, and x minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 6. Okay, I solved this exact same question in my video teaching Gaussian elimination with matrices, and it took a lot of work. Now again, I'm going to do a decent amount of writing, but that's only to teach you the process. A lot of this, you don't want to skip too much, make any careless mistakes, but it does go fairly quickly. So we're going to once again identify matrix C as our coefficient matrix. So we have C is equal to the, well, let's go ahead and find the determinant of C. That way I don't have to write quite as much. The determinant of C is equal to the determinant of 2, 4, and 1. 1, negative 2, and negative 2. And negative 2, negative 1, and 3. Okay. So we just learned in a previous video about solving or finding determinants of these larger matrices. We need to take the first two columns and copy them again to the right of the original matrix. So we're going to do 2, 4, and 1, negative 2, negative 2. We're going to do diagonals from the upper left-hand corner down to the right. Now I do want to try and fit all of this up on the screen at one time, so I'm going to do a little bit of this in my head. We have 2 times negative 2 is equal to negative 4, and negative 4 times 3 is negative 12. So we have negative 12 from that first diagonal. Then we're going to have 1 times negative 1 is negative 1, times 1 down here is still negative 1, so plus negative 1, because we do want to add those elements that we get from multiplying through those diagonals. And then we have plus negative 2 times 4 is negative 8, and negative 8 times negative 2 is positive 16. And we're going to add all this up. We have negative 12 and negative 1 is negative 13 plus 16 is equal to 3. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and multiply through the diagonal going from the upper right-hand corner down through all of these rows. So, and we're going to add those as well. So we have 1 times 4 is negative is 4 times 3 is 12 plus 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4 plus negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4 times 1 is 4 again. And we get 12 and 4 is 16, and 16 and 4 is equal to 20. Now we want to take our sum from the second, from the first set of diagonals and subtract it with the sum from the second set of diagonals. So our full determinant is going to be equal to, the determinant of C is going to be equal to 3 minus 20. And give us negative 17. And since I'm talking and writing at the same time and making sure this is all good, I want to make sure my answers are right. Okay, so we have now reviewed again how to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. Let's try and set up what we're going to do to solve for x. Let's see here, what color have I not used yet? Green. So x is going to be equal to the determinant. Remember we did in the previous question, we took out the coefficients of x and plugged in the constant column. So we're going to do negative 1, 5, and 6, and then go back to our original coefficient matrix and keep all those values. So we're going to do 1, negative 2, and negative 2, and negative 2, negative 2, or excuse me, negative 1, and 3, and that is going to be the determinant, again, with those constants in there for replacing the coefficients of x over negative 17, the determinant of C. Now, I don't think you really want to see me do a bunch of arithmetic in my head, so let me step out, give you the solution, we'll repeat it for Y and X, and, or Z, excuse me, and give you a chance to make sure that you can find these determinants correctly on your own as well. So, let me step out, reveal the solution, and then we'll come back and set up for Y. So I've taken those first two columns, copied them, did my diagonals, multiplied and subtracted. We ended up with x equaling negative 17 over 17, negative 17, which of course means that x is equal to 1. I'm going to erase this and write that summary down after we get to setting up our value of y. So y is going to be, again, this matrix. Let's put the coefficients of x back in, 2, 4, and 1. Put those constants now in for the y column, or replace the coefficients of y with those constants, negative 1, 5, and 6. Then go back to negative 2, negative 1, and 3. Again, that's going to be over 17, negative 17, excuse me. So let's repeat finding that determinant again for y, keeping it over negative 17, and see what that answer comes out to. Okay, so we have a y value that's equal to negative 1. So let's see here, I forgot to write the little summary down. We got x equals, what was it, 1. We have y is equal to negative 1 because we have 17 divided by negative 17. And then of course we're going to repeat this one more time for z, which I'm just going to write the answer down. We have z is equal to 2, 4, and 1. And determinant of, and we got 1, negative 2, and negative 2, and now we're going to put those constants in for the coefficients of z, which is negative 1, 5, and 6 again, over the determinant of c, which was again negative 17. This ends up coming out to be, once again, negative 17 over negative 17, which comes out to be 1, so z is equal to 1. So it's still a little bit tedious with writing these determinants out and doing the diagonals and multiplying and such, but this went much, much quicker than doing the same question with the Gaussian elimination method. So you can see that it definitely has some very good benefits of helping you get your homework done faster. And it is time for me to get out of here. So, I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.